Good morning. It is our 9 a.m. update on the coronavirus. Let me start the way I always start. We will get through this. We are going to have to disrupt each and every one of our lives. There's going to be a lot of changes as we move forward, but we are going to make it through this. Now, to make it through this the way that we want to, protecting the maximum number of people, we need each and every Kentuckian's help. I want you, as you think about this coronavirus, to truly internalize that we all have a duty to do everything we can that it takes to beat this virus. This is our duty as Kentuckians. This is our patriotic duty. That's where we are. And to me, it is our Christian duty to help our fellow man and woman. So make sure that you are following the type of practices that we need so that we can ultimately protect Kentuckians to the very best degree. I need your help. I know that there is anxiety out there. I know a lot of it is spread through social media. So I want your help. I want to fill social media with the positive things that we should be doing. Whether that is helping a neighbor, whether it is being a good shopper and not taking more than you need, whether that is ordering takeout to support small businesses, whether that is canceling a meeting or an event, I want people to start talking about their duty and living their patriotic duty on social media. We got a couple of hashtags that we want you to start using. Kenneth, if you could pull those up. We've talked about all being a part of the same team. One hashtag is Team Kentucky, and the second hashtag is Together KY. We need to model really good citizenship, and we need to understand that it is all of our jobs to do what it takes to protect our people. Kentuckians, you are great people. We need you to be the very best people that you can be in how we address this. Got a couple of folks that are here with us today. Judge Chris Pace from Clark County and the Clark County Health Department, Rebecca Kissick. They are here showing their solidarity now that we have a confirmed case in Clark County. Their leadership, like leadership in all of our communities, is so critical. We appreciate our local officials and everything that they are doing, and our health departments are amazing. And thank goodness for them. We appreciate their work. They're going to be even more important in the coming days. I want to repeat again, it is our civic duty to do everything that we can to make sure that we are living up to our patriotic duty and that we are following all the instructions that we get. Here's one of the reasons that it's so important. Today, we're reporting that we lost the individual that we knew was in bad shape. They are the Bourbon County resident. They have passed away. I want to give my sympathies to that family, and I hope everybody out there is praying for him. Bill Sisson from Baptist Health Lexington also sends his absolute best. This is why it's important. There were numerous factors that led to this point. The coronavirus was only a factor, but what it means is that it's very important that we all do our patriotic duty as we move forward to model the type of behavior that we need. My family and every Kentuckian is lifting up this individual's friends, family, and community in our thoughts and prayers. We are a resilient people. We will move forward. We will get through this, but we need everybody doing their part. Some good news. 14 of the 16 members, Kentuckians that were on the Grand Princess are now home. I know it took too long to get them home, but we are happy to have them home. They arrived last night, and we know each and every one of them is now at their home, and we are excited for it. We have a motor coach on the way to pick up the last two that had to be flown from Lachlan to Dobbins, and we look forward to getting them home today. We know everybody that is a part of that group has not been treated right, but we are doing everything we can, and I will tell you, I've been personally doing everything I can to get you home. Where we are today is 21 confirmed cases. We'll have another update at the end of today, and starting tomorrow, we'll go to one of these a day, each day at 4 o'clock. We're doing a lot in state government right now, and I've got to make sure we're not pulling people off the front lines, but we will be here each and every day at 4 to give you the newest updates and to talk about the ways that we're going to go about this. Tomorrow, my hope is to start with an age appropriate presentation where people's kids can watch and learn a little bit about the coronavirus. We're working on that right now. So as of today, 21 cases, 66-year-old male from Bourbon County who we have lost, and we're not going to quibble over it being a contributing factor or not. We are going to list this as the first death here in Kentucky. Again, we are thinking about their family, his family. The second is a 40-year-old female from Fayette County, a 46-year-old male from Fayette County, a 31-year-old female from Fayette County, a 47-year-old male from Fayette County, a 31-year-old male from Fayette County. And from Harrison, we have a 27-year-old female who is home and fully through it, and that's what we want for everybody. A 67-year-old female, a 68-year-old male, a 54-year-old female, 60-year-old male, 51-year-old male. From Jefferson, 69-year-old male, 67-year-old female. We still need full confirmation of that one. 68-year-old female, 80-year-old female, 73-year-old female. From Montgomery County, a 56-year-old male. From Nelson County, a 53-year-old male. From Clark County, a 49-year-old male. And then the latest case is a 54-year-old male in Jefferson County. So that is where we are today. But folks, we are going to have more cases. And we've got to expect more cases. And that's why we are taking the steps that we have taken to date. Kenneth, if you could show our line graph slide. What we are doing is making sure that we take aggressive action. Much of this action is being taken across the country. To do everything we can to try to lessen a steep increase in cases and positives that we really need to avoid. We need to avoid that steep increase so that our healthcare system has the resources to take care of those that are sick. And our hope is that by doing it, we could hopefully also reduce the total number of cases. That is certainly what I want to do. If we continue business as usual, if people don't do their patriotic duty, in this graph, which, Kenneth, can people see this at home that are watching? In this graph, that blue line shows you what our cases will be. Kentucky, we're not going to do that. We're going to do our duty. We're going to reduce those contacts. And I want to get us down as much as we can towards that bottom red line. Think about how well that protects our people. Think about how our resources will be there for your loved one that may need them. So again, we're asking each and every person to do their duty to make sure that we are that red line. Now, Kenneth, can you show the Philadelphia to St. Louis? Why we are taking this aggressive action, when you may say, but Andy, we have 21 cases, is when we look back, and this is the Spanish flu, not taking action, being late by just a couple weeks can make a huge difference. What you see on Philadelphia is not taking the necessary social distancing steps until weeks after the first case. And what you see is a huge spike that resulted in the types of things happening there that we do not want to see in Kentucky, and I'm going to do everything I have to keep it from happening in Kentucky. But then in the behavior that we want to model, what we see in St. Louis is aggressive steps that better protected their people. So we want to be a lot more like St. Louis, but we want to be better. know, I'd like to think that we want to lead here in Kentucky. So let's make sure that all of us are following the practices we need to. You may be in an age group, you may be in great health where you feel indestructible, and you might be with this virus. But if you spread it to somebody else, now that's where the harm can come in. So again, everybody, you know, remain calm. It's 80% of you are going to be just fine, plus if you get it. And the rest, we're going to make sure that we have what we need to take care of. But we've got to make sure that we are engaging in the right type of activity so that we are not spreading this to other people. I'm going to go through the list, like we do every day, of steps we have taken to date, and then we're going to talk about new steps that we are taking. And again, some of those will be significant, but we're going to continue to take more and more and more steps to make sure that we are not business as usual, that we are reducing our contacts, and that we are modeling St. Louis and not Philadelphia. To those I know in Philadelphia, we're sorry, but we got to make sure that we follow that better model. So we declared a state of emergency, which gives us significant authority to address this crisis, this healthcare outbreak as we are seeing it. We activated the Emergency Management Operations Center, and today we are moving that to level 3. And what that does is it puts people in seats. It allows us to have heightened preparedness. It's just going to make sure that we are out there continuing to plan for every opportunity. And we've activated the State Health Operations Center. That's called the Shock Center. We announced Kentucky's COVID-19 hotline, 1-800-722-5725. Let's show that if we can, Kenneth. You can show the website. That number is incredibly important. We're having about 2,000 calls a day. That is a good thing. We have to make sure that we do not overwhelm our healthcare facilities. So also, we have our main resource for those that want information. That's our state website. If we can put that up, kycovid19.ky.gov. kycovid19.ky.gov. In a world where there is so much social media and other information, this is the real information. Go to this website to get your Kentucky-specific information. This is where we can tell you we are giving you accurate information. We got an infographic on here that I'm going to ask Kenneth to pull up. Very important. It's about being a good neighbor, doing our patriotic duty. If you are well, but you are nervous, don't go to a healthcare facility, call the hotline. If you are sick but otherwise would not have sought care, think colds, think allergies, don't go to a healthcare facility. We don't overwhelm them. Call the hotline. But if you are truly sick and would have sought care and or injured, get the care that you need. This is going to be really important that we get into this practice now. To make sure that if we have a spike of cases, that we have the right practices out there, that we are all in that rhythm, and that we are making sure that we are being the responsible citizens that we need to be. We issued an executive order to prohibit price gouging. If you see it, dial 888-432-9257. We are asking all businesses to implement sick leave policies, and if you can, paid sick leave, to make sure that we have incentives for people to stay home that are sick. We are doing that in state government. We have had to make changes, just like I know businesses out there will have to make changes. We are continuing to publish the CDC guidelines. Remember, the most vulnerable are those over 60, those with heart, lung, and kidney disease, compromised immune systems, diabetics, especially for those folks. Very rigidly follow all of these guidelines. Don't fly. Don't get on a cruise ship. We have recommended social distancing now for everybody. Staying home as much as possible, though you can certainly get outside. It's healthy for you. But 6 feet from other individuals, avoid crowds, practice great hygiene, wash your hands multiple times a day, soap and water, clean and disinfect your house. If you're at work, you're where you work. If you can't find supplies, and we are working on that, a 1-100 bleach solution will work to clean things. And remember that soap and water works better than hand sanitizer. So continue to wash your hands. We have issued an executive order to waive copays, deductibles, cost sharing, diagnostic test fees as it relates to private insurance and state employees. We're also taking steps in Medicaid to make sure that when we have widespread testing, that there is no disincentive. Again, we hope that in the near future that there will be widespread testing. We don't have a timeline for that. And every time we get a timeline, it seems to be extended. So I'm preparing, and we are preparing, for the reality that we have on the ground. And that requires us to test the most sick, those that are in the population that is most vulnerable. And we've all got to understand in these times, even with our anxiety, that being a good neighbor is critical in how we use our resources. I'm going to do everything I can to push for that day, and we are certainly preparing for it, where we will have widespread testing, and we will be ready the moment that that capability is in Kentucky to do it. Next, we are working with all 120 county judges, updating them through the Emergency Management Network, and we're gonna be asking them, I know they're already be doing it, to do different planning in their community as we take more aggressive steps like closing senior centers. We need their leadership in making sure that we're taking care of our individuals. And this is a test of our compassion, of making sure that every time a service that's out there that it is tough to close and we close it, that we step up and we still look out for each other. Remember, fear, if it overwhelms you, will cause more harm to you than this coronavirus ever will. To us as a society, fear can cause more harm than this coronavirus ever will. Coming together, realizing that at this point, there are no Democrats, there are no Republicans, there are just Kentuckians, and it is our job to defeat this coronavirus. All of us together, every single day, doing what we need to do to get through this and to protect our people. That is our calling now, and we need each and every one of your help. Signed an executive order allowing pharmacy refills for up to 30 days. And if we need to stage pharmacies outside of their brick and mortar, we are going to do that. If we have to extend that 30 days, we'll do that too. We've limited visits to long-term care facilities and nursing homes except in end-of-life situations. I haven't said this in a couple of days. I know that's hard. And I know that it's already been some time since we've done it, and there's gonna be some more time into the future. Please call your relative, FaceTime, do whatever it is that you can do, but it is absolutely necessary to their safety that we take these steps. We have closed down school districts to in-class, certainly in-person classes. We see our school districts stepping up to be able to provide as much instruction as possible. We need our kids to stay on a schedule for their mental health. We need them to be engaged. And I want to thank all of our school districts for everything you're doing, from that NTI, which is non-traditional instruction, to the meals that you are continuing to provide. Keep thinking about ways that we can help our people. We closed all state prisons to visitors. I know jails around the state are or should be doing the same. We advise that community gatherings should be canceled or postponed. We suspended out-of-state travel for state employees. We encourage all businesses to allow as many of your employees to work from home. If that includes all your employees and you were able to do it, you should be doing it at this point. We've recommended a temporary closure of senior centers. Again, that is to protect the most vulnerable. We're doing everything we can on the meal side to make sure that we're providing it. And we announced through the Kentucky Employers Mutual Insurance that we'll be providing wage replacement benefits for first responders and medical personnel that are our front lines. We announced our boards and commissions are canceling any in-person meetings and using video teleconference. That there will be public access with a link to each and every one of those meetings. We followed the emergency declaration from the Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration, which provides regulatory relief for commercial drivers that are helping us battle the coronavirus. We issued guidance to state agencies. We're going to try to decrease by at least 50% our in-person staffing. I've now done a lot of these, so please forgive my voice. We asked Kentucky's hospitals to cease elective procedures by close of business Wednesday, March 18th. We are working with those systems, but let me say to any hospital or system that is not taking this seriously, you have to. We have to be ready, if we have a spike of cases, to take care of every Kentuckian who needs it. So we want to make sure that in our healthcare industry that there is no resistance to doing the right thing. This is your patriotic duty, just like it is everybody else's. We've guaranteed that the testing for COVID-19, once we have the ability for widespread testing, is going to be free to all Kentuckians, even the uninsured. We're asking child care centers to create plans of closure that they could implement within 72 hours. We anticipate that we will give that instruction this week. So child care centers, please be prepared to close later this week. It's again necessary. I know it is difficult. We will have some exceptions for our healthcare workers. They have to be able to get into work. There will be a few other exceptions that are out there. Again, a tough step, but one that is absolutely necessary to protect Kentuckians. We had to take, for the first time, steps to force home isolation of a patient that tested positive. Again, just be a good teammate, do your duty, but we will take the steps that we have to take. And we have issued guidance to help support good mental health, get physical exercise, take care of yourself during this. The more you do that, the better. All right, new steps that were taken today, and we are going to continue to take steps as they move forward, expect that. Kentuckians, the more we can do to reduce contacts, the better, and we're going to continue to do it. So I mentioned that our EOC moved to level 3. Again, that helps us with preparation and response. I'm going to put out the order today to close all restaurants and bars to in-person traffic. We are going to have exceptions in there for drive-through, for delivery, but we are to the point now where this is a step we have to take. After talking yesterday about what happens if we don't, I want to thank everybody who stepped up, some of them sending me messages personally, and we're doing this voluntarily. You were doing your duty. But we are asking so many people to make sacrifices from the school system and others. This is a step that we have to take. We're going to do everything we can to help with the financial impact. It's not lost on me that most of these are small businesses. And there are those that are watching that have spent your sweat equity and maybe even your life savings to open that small business. We're going to do everything we can to be there for you. I want you to know that I realize the impact that it's going to have, but we have to take the steps to make sure that we are protecting our people, and this is a necessary one. Today, we're also going to take the steps to waive the waiting period for unemployment for folks that are losing their jobs because of the coronavirus, and we will waive any work search requirements while the state of emergency is in effect. We know that the steps we're taking are going to cause people to lose their job. We want you to be able to qualify for unemployment, and we don't want to create impediments that keep you from being able to get through this, which we are going to make sure that we get through it together. All right, beginning tomorrow morning, we are going to close the state capitol to non-essential personnel. That, again, is a big step. And I am a person who ran on these doors being open for everyone all the time. We're dealing with something that we could have never anticipated. And at the end, my obligation is to keep people safe as we move forward. This is a step where we are modeling what we're asking other people to be modeling. So we'll have more details on that. But again, we are taking the steps that are necessary. Also want to announce that we have two state government officials in self-isolation, our Transportation Cabinet Secretary Jim Gray and Edith Hallbleib, who heads the industrial, can you help me out? The industrial infrastructure. She's over connected to DLG. We will get that title. Both are feeling just fine. It is out of an abundance of caution. And again, we are trying to model as best we can the behavior we need from everybody else. Folks, we're going to continue to take these steps. What we need you to do is to remain calm and to handle this disruption and this anxiety as it comes. We are going to get through this. We are taking aggressive action to protect you and the people around you. What I'm asking you to do starting today, though many of you have done this, is to consider it your duty as a Kentuckian and as an American to follow the guidance that we are putting up. The more you internalize that, the more you do it, the better neighbor you are and the better protected we will be as a state. So I know that was a very long resuscitation. We'll open it up to some questions.
Governor
Tom.
With the closing of the Capitol tomorrow, what does that mean for the legislative session?
So I believe that we will see the leadership talk about steps that they are going to take as far as the third floor and the annex. It would certainly be my guidance to them to get us a budget as quickly as we can. And we'll see what that budget includes. You know, I was very proud to put forth a budget where for the first time in 12 years, we were making real investments. We're to the point where we're going to have to get through this coronavirus and see what investments we can make at that point. But we are in a different time. And what's most important is that they get us a budget. And then we can come back if we have to at a later date. And my hope is to have more dollars to put into important places.
So you're going to be issuing an order today to close all bars and restaurants to in-person traffic statewide?
Yes.
How?
Let me repeat the question.
Yeah.
It was confirming that we're going to be closing all bars and restaurants to in-person traffic statewide today. Yes, we will be putting out that order.
When will that take effect? And can you talk a little bit more about the impact that you're expecting on workers?
Well, my goal is that the order will take effect as of about 5 p.m. today. That's my goal. We're working fast, and we want to make sure that we are not operating 2 weeks too late, like Philadelphia did in that model that we put up. It's going to have a major impact on workers. One of the reasons that we're changing unemployment, waiving the days that it takes, it's going to have a major impact on a lot of people out there. And I want them to know that we understand. But we will get through this. We will all bounce back. We will rebuild what has to be rebuilt. We are a resilient people. We've proven it time and time again. We're going to prove it here, too.
And how will that work with takeout? Because it sounds like you're still, they're allowed
yes,
to do that.
There are going to be exceptions for drive-thrus, for takeout that we need to look at exactly how that's done, and for delivery. And let me ask again, as part of our duty, we need folks that are out there to be ordering takeout now, to be ordering delivery. You know, my family's going to commit to do it for at least 3 meals a week. There are 4 of us. We need everybody else to do that too. These are our important businesses. They employ people throughout our community. I know it's a little strange to think about patriotic duty in ordering takeout. It is important.
And we
can't allow that. So we have to. The question was, what about large lines or crowds outside of restaurants? That's something that we can't allow to happen. So we'll make sure in our order, whether it is if it's curbside, it's going to need to be brought to you. If it is drive-through, that ought to work. But we'll put out guidance on that again. If you are a restaurant that is going to switch to this model or is already in this model, you have to think about how you lessen those contacts. It is all of our responsibility. And to those that had already stepped up after my comments yesterday, thank you. Thank you for setting the example. Had a number of groups, Country Boy Brewing sent me a personal text. I want to thank them for their example and so many others out there. The new information out of Bourbon County is that unfortunately we have lost the patient there that had tested positive. We are thinking about him and his family. While the coronavirus wasn't the only cause, it was a contributing factor. And it just reminds us that while we got to remain calm and we're going to get through this, it is serious and it truly impacts people. So think about the ramifications as an individual if you're not following this guidance. It's probably somebody else's loved one that might end up in harm's way. Let me read a couple questions. With the new CDC guidance to cancel or postpone in-person events that consist of 50 people or more for the next 8 weeks, what is your recommendation for events such as Thunder over Louisville and the Kentucky Derby? My belief is that we are going to hear shortly about that. I don't want to get ahead of any of those announcements. Another individual, is the time coming to close down state government for a few weeks except for essential services? We are going to be taking steps to stop any in-person service that is needed from state government. We're going to do whatever it takes to make sure that we can provide those services remotely, and we'll be changing regulations for the short term to do that. Let me say, we're also going to put out an order later today that extends people's driver's license if they would otherwise be expiring for the next 90 days. We don't want you to have to come in person to get that license reissued. And we have so much that we do that requires person-to-person right now. We're going to take each one as they come. I got a question of what is the per-day testing capacity of U of L and LabCorp? I don't have that information. LabCorp is obviously a national lab, and we'd have to reach out to see that. We all want the day where the major private labs can provide a test to everyone who needs it, and we are preparing for that scenario. We just got to be ready for it to be sometime further out in the future. How soon does LabCorp expect to set up drive-through testing in Kentucky? We don't have a date for that. We will deal with our situation on the ground until it is available. And my pledge to you is the moment that it's available, we will be up, we will be running. We will do everything we can to get it to everyone. We are planning and replanning for it every day. Did I meet with Robert Stivers or David Osborne on Sunday to discuss what to do with the General Assembly? I talked individually with them by phone, and then we'll allow them to make any additional announcements. We have, would it be possible to let us know how many people in eastern Kentucky have been tested for the coronavirus and the breakdown of counties and hospitals where the tests took place and the results? We are working on being able to post counties that have had tests or even negative tests, but folks, we expect to have a case of the coronavirus in every area of the state. And we should not be thinking that just because there hasn't been one in our county that we should not be following this guidance. Absolutely critical that everybody out there follow these practices, whether there has been one reported in your region or not. Questions on unemployment, I think I addressed. Well, this is a personal one. As the father of two, how do you calm fears, and what advice, resources do you have for parents? I'm working through this every day, just like you all are. My kids show the anxiety, and it's my job as a parent to reassure them, to spend time with them, to get them outside, to make sure they have exercise, to make sure they have intellectual stimulation. We're going to try tomorrow to have somebody here right at the beginning for an age-appropriate discussion for kids. So if you want to tune in, we'll do it tomorrow at 4 with your children. We'll start with that, and then We'll move into the normal one that I give. I hope that is one where we can speak directly to children and also to parents. But it's again, going to be very different for kids. So keep them on their schedule as much as they can. This isn't a time for letting people sleep in. Keep the bedtime, keep the wake-up time. If there is non-traditional instruction your kids are doing, schedule it during times when they would otherwise be doing it in school and make sure they are healthy. You know, one thing that we can learn coming out of this is not just practicing good hygiene, but let's get as healthy as we can as a state. And one of the reasons that we're being so aggressive is that we have so many folks that are at risk because of heart, lung, or kidney disease. And everything that we can do in this to model good physical, mental, and emotional help is going to be helpful as we move into the future. With the rapid increase of calls to the coronavirus hotline, is the state looking into ways to absorb the increase in calls? Yes, that is run through Norton Healthcare. They are hiring more people, and it's asked if the state has more funding to help. We are in a state of emergency, so we'll tap into all of the funding that is at our disposal. Do we believe that there are more cases of the coronavirus in Kentucky than what are reported due to lack of available testing? We believe that there are more cases out there than are being reported, but that's not just due to a lack of testing. If we had the widespread testing that we hope to have in the future, yes, we would discover that there are many more positive cases, and we expect to see that. But the main reason that we know that there are more cases out there is for 80% folks, you're going to be just fine. You might not show any symptoms, or you will show mild symptoms. And so that's part of that duty to reduce our contacts, that you might have this coronavirus and not even know it. So your patriotic duty is to make sure you're protecting yourself and others throughout the course of this. So folks, we're going to continue to move forward. Again, we are going to make it through. I need everybody to remain calm, for you, for your neighbors, but I need you to follow this advice. Let's protect the most vulnerable out there. Yes, let's take two more.
There was a report that the Federal Health and Human Services Department had a cyber attack over the weekend, and I was just wondering what, if anything, the state's doing to try to prepare, if you're worried about that being an issue for you guys.
We do need to make sure that at this time that others across the world don't try to take advantage of us. We need to be prepared for that. And so we have a Department of Homeland Security that's here that works with others to make sure that we are protecting ourselves the best we can. All right. So again, let me end by saying that we got the greatest people here in Kentucky of anywhere in the world. And what always drives us is our sense of home, our sense of belonging, our sense of how special Kentucky is. I need everybody to step up and to live that, not just to feel it, but to live it. You know, as we go through these next couple of weeks or even months, the steps that you take to be a good neighbor protect the people around you. Again, social distancing is not isolation. You can be 6 feet away from somebody and have a good conversation, and you need to continue to have personal interaction. Use all the tools that you have, if you have FaceTime or if you have others, to communicate with loved ones that you can't see. And take care of yourself. You know, people are going to be more at home moving forward than maybe they have been in their entire lives. So just take care of yourself. It's okay to take time. You certainly should shut off the news at different times. Don't do this 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I know what that's like. Please. Those around you need your reassurance, and they need to reassure you. But we're going to make it. We're going to come out the other side. We're going to be stronger for it. We're just going to take the steps along the way to protect all of those Kentuckians who are most vulnerable. It is us against the coronavirus, all of us together. No more divisions. No more things that we argue that keep us apart. Just us together getting through this. Thank you all very much.